Hi everyone, Arlene here. Welcome back to my Country Craft Corner. How in the world are you guys doing today? It is so good to see you again, and thank you so much for stopping back by to see what I'm up to. And what I'm up to today is, well, I'm on my way to Michael's because one of you guys sent me a lovely gift certificate. I was blown away, you guys. Oh my goodness, via email. So I've printed it off and I'm on my way to Michael's and I'm going to purchase myself something for $25, which is the amount that the gift certificate was given. And so I'm thinking that I will try to find something for around that much money so that I can always remember that person for giving me this particular item. I've done that in the past when y'all have given me gift certificates. I try to purchase something for that amount, just one thing. So it's not a bunch of little things that are spread throughout. I like to be able to remember whoever gives me things by when I look at this one thing. So that's what I'm on my way to do. I'm recording this on Sunday. Y'all probably will see this Tuesday morning. I thought I would go ahead and tell you about my birthday while I'm on my way to Michael's. And then I'll show you what I pick up from Michael's and a gift that Kristen got for me and Chris got for me, which is cute. It's a cute little gift. And then Candace and Dustin brought food to share. So that was kind of my birthday present. So that's what she brought, crab dip, and they brought like a garlic and herb dip and crackers and a whole spread of stuff. So it's like, you know, oh my goodness. Of course my dad was there and my girls were there and Dustin was there and of course Chris. And that to me was the biggest birthday present ever, y'all. To have my family with me on my birthday, on my real birthday, was just amazing. It was just amazing, you guys. I cannot tell you how much that meant to me. I mean, I don't remember a time since the girls lived at home that everybody, my dad and everybody was there, you know. So that really made it very, very, very special. So let me back up and I'll throw up some pictures here and show you. My girls will not let me share their pictures, which I totally respect and understand. And of course, I might throw a picture of Chris and myself in here. He doesn't care if I show you pictures. He won't be seen in person on video. But hang on, let me get out of here. But he doesn't mind if I throw up a picture every now and again, you know. So, but Dad had called yesterday morning to say that he was leaving his house right about 8:30, quarter of nine. And it takes him about 2.5 hours to 2.5 hours to get here. And so he pulled in right after noon. And here we are in our driveway right after he pulled in. And such a happy fella all the time. I'm telling you, he's my heart, you guys. He's so happy. He's such a good man. Good man. So here are a couple pictures of us out there. And he opens his trunk up and he goes, here we go, you know. And he usually will give me money for my birthday. This year, he said, I'm going to bring the food, you know, for us to eat on your birthday. And I said, okay. So here he came with king crab legs, y'all. And shrimp, big fat shrimp. Oh my goodness, I'll show you some pictures of our platters here in a little bit. But so we got in his trunk and Chris came out and we all, you know, went in. Both the girls were there and Dustin was there. Everybody kind of arrived at the same time. So it was kind of a little hullabaloo, you know, getting everybody there and hugging and saying hi. And you know how family is, just it's so good to see everybody, you know. And so we just sat around and talked and, you know, visited for a while, got everybody a cup of coffee, cup of tea, whatever, and just sat and chatted. And my girls hadn't seen each other in person for a while, so they really got caught up, which was good. And then I saw my dad and he started walking around and there he went, you guys. Like I've told you guys, I've explained to you that he just goes and he starts looking. He said, I've never seen your house decorated like this, Arlen. I said, I know you haven't, Dad, I know. And y'all know, yesterday morning when I flipped on my lights, guess what lights did not work? My mantle swag didn't work. I said, of all things not to work, the other parts of the mantle worked. The lights on the top of the mantle worked, and you know, everything else worked. The little pumpkins, they worked. It's just what was on the swag, just what was on the garland. I was like, I'm sorry, Dad, this is supposed to light up, so just imagine. He said, it's okay, I got it. So he was very touched when he saw, you know, the my grandmother's hutch, you know, that I used Mom's doll as a you know, as an inspiration. He goes, oh, that's so nice. And he loved the secretary with Mom's picture up on the top of it. You know, he loved that. He said, this is really pretty, I really like this. And he liked that, and he just went on and on and on. And he said, man, oh man, Arlen, you did a job, you did a great job. And you know, you guys, he touches my heart. If I didn't do such a great job, he'd still say, Arlen, you did a great job, just because he's that encouraging. You know, he's an encouraging person. But he really loved it. And then later in the evening, he and I took a walk out front, you know. So, but anyway, we walked around and then we all sat down and just talked and visited. And, Kristen wanted me to open her gift. She brought me in a gift. I said, because I told him, I said, I don't want gifts, you guys. I don't need gifts. I don't want gifts. My gift is you guys coming. Kristen never listens to me. She never did as a child. I'm just kidding. Sorry, I've got tears in my eyes. Sorry. But here she came with a gift. So I opened it up and I'll show it to you when I get home, because I did not wear it. I didn't put it on. I didn't know I was going to do this video today, or I would have had it on. And maybe I'll put it on at home and show you when I get back to the house. But she got me a beautiful Brighton necklace, y'all. Beautiful Brighton, and it has a story behind it. So I'll tell you about that when I get home. Beautiful. And she's the one that always, you know, has gotten me my Brighton bracelet. She's really good at picking that stuff out, and she's really good at sentiments, you know, and matching gifts for what's going on in your life at the time, you know. So then after we got that open and I cried and thanked her and hugged her and oh my goodness, then Chris started cooking. Chris was the cooker of the shrimp and of the crab legs, and Dad was out there with him in the kitchen. And we got Dad some ketchup out and some horseradish, and we said, here, make up some cocktail sauce. So he's up there mixing up his cocktail sauce. And he also brought macaroni salad. I was going to make my macaroni salad. He says, no. He says, I'm bringing all the food. I said, yes, sir. Okay. He said, it's your birthday. You're not doing anything. And I'm telling you, they didn't let me, you guys. They didn't let me. Girls did the dishes. Dustin helped carry dishes over. Chris did all the cooking. Dad helped Chris cook. I didn't do anything. I had a cup of tea, and I sat there and watched and was like, wow. You know, I feel like I was so touched, you know. So then we all surrounded around the table and held hands, and we said a prayer. Dad prayed for us, you know, for meal and traveling mercies for everybody, and, you know, really sweet prayer. And then here's the table right before we sat down. Excuse the paper plates. We put paper plates on because we had to put our crab shells and our shrimp peels, you know, somewhere. We didn't want to put them on our plate we were eating off of. But here's the table. Here's the table set. Just the tablescape, if you want to call it that, with my tablecloth and my little table, my little centerpiece. And so, boy, we had a feast. We had a feast. Boy, howdy, did we have a feast. It was good. It was delicious. And so after that, we did the dishes, and then out came my Nacho Mama's banana pudding. And Dad, I did not realize that I had not made this for my dad ever. And I'm like, where in the world, why wouldn't I have? And you know why, you guys? Because even in the summertime, I make my strawberry shortcake. Thanksgiving, I make, you know, pecan pies, and Chris makes pecan pies. I don't. And I sometimes will do a pumpkin pie. It's more of a, like a, it's almost like a cheesecake pumpkin casserole. I make it in a 13 by 9 inch, and it's really fluffy and it's really good. So I make that sometimes and place a pumpkin pie. And then Christmas time is always my peanut butter fudge and the peanut butter pie and the cheesecake and the this and the that and the other thing. So I guess I've never really had an occasion where I just made not your mama's banana pudding. So I hear I came with this and he goes, "Woo!" He loves his sweets. He loves his sweets. Yeah, I get my sweet tooth from him for sure. He goes, "Oh," he said, "what is this?" I said, "Well, Dad, this is called not your mama's banana pudding." And he said, "Oh my goodness." And we divvy it out by the cookies, like, you know, he said, and I said, "Well, how many cookies do you want? You want one cookie's worth?" We went to, he said, "Give me two cookies worth." I said, "Okay." I cut him up two cookies worth and served everybody else out. He went nuts over that. He said, "Arlen, this is so good. Oh my goodness, this is so good. You've never made this for me." I said, "Well, Dad, I can't believe I've never had this. This is so good. This is not like any kind of banana pudding I've ever had." He said, "This is so good." And he wasn't just saying it just to, you know, he meant it. And I said, "Oh my goodness, okay, Dad." So he goes, he finished this plate and he goes, "Okay, I'd like two more cookies, please." So he had seconds and I was like, "Okay, you must really like it." He says, "I love it. Could I have sent him home with some this morning?" "No." I said, "How about you take some of that banana?" No. "I'm back on my diet today. I can't." He's always really good about his weight, about his diet. And, you know, I'm grateful, you know, he takes such good care of himself. But boy, everybody loved that not your mama's banana pudding. That went over like really well. So, after we got done eating, we all just kind of collapsed. You know, we always all sat around in the family room and just talked and talked. Dad had football on, and then the kids started trickling. You know, Dustin and Candace left with V. "Oh, I forgot to show you Valentino. Here's Valentino sitting up on the back of the couch like Mr. King that he is." And then, of course, sweet Sam, you know, he was just laying around, got up and greeted everybody very gently and very sweetly, as he always does, you know. But he was just kind of just hanging out and laying there and being Sam, you know. And Valentino's running circles around him. He's a cute little dog. But then they just started, I guess Candace and Dustin and Chris, they all left at the same time. It was about 7 o'clock, 6:30, 7 o'clock yesterday evening, I guess. And so they went ahead and went home, and Dad and Chris and I settled down and we were watching more sports. My dad loves his sports, and you know, we were watching the playoffs, and man, we were rooting for the Astros, Kim, there at Sweet Daisy Creations. We were rooting for the Astros. I don't care for the Yankees. Shh, don't tell anybody that, but I don't want them to, you know. So I was rooting for the Astros to beat the Yankees. But they didn't. Lost 5-0 or something like that. Anyway, I was frustrated. I was like, "Come on, you guys." So Dad and I, and then Chris tootled off to bed because he goes to bed early, and Dad and I just sat up and chatted, and you know, and then he headed up to the purple bedroom. That's where he stayed, and off to bed he went, you know, and then got up this morning and we sat around and talked and had a big time this morning, just had tea and, you know, couldn't push breakfast on him. He had a banana. Dad had not a piece of banana pudding, but just a banana. And, that was it. And he left about 10:30-ish, something like that. And I just got I said, "Just ring my phone when you get home." So he just rang my phone when he got home. It was one of the best birthdays I've ever had, you guys. One of the best birthdays I've ever had. Family, to me, is the end all, be all. I needed nothing more than that. And, you know, of course, I love my necklace and I will wear it on my cruise. And I'll explain more about that when I show it to you. But I just, you know, I absolutely love it. And Kristen is such a, just the biggest heart in the whole wide world. Both of them are. Both of my girls. Wow, oh my goodness. Anyway, I can't tell you. I can't tell you guys. I'm just so blessed to have my family. To have the family that I have. You know, I'm just, and not a day goes by that I don't realize that. You know, that I don't grasp that and thank the Lord for that. You know, every day, you guys, every day I do. So, I am now 58. Don't feel a minute older, to be honest, but I'm 58. And I'm very thankful that I don't have any health problems other than, like I've said, that, you know, the occasional old age ache and bad knees, which I've always had. So, you know, I feel pretty good, you know, for 58. So, but anyway, I'm in some traffic here, so I'm going to let you guys go. It's Sunday afternoon here in Spotsylvania. It's not a fun time to be driving. And so I'm going to let you guys go, and I will come back at the house, and I'll show you that beautiful necklace that Kristen got me, and what Chris got me, which you'll chuckle about, and I'll show you whatever I pick out from my sweet subby here from Michael's. All right. Also, I got, I haven't had a chance, I'm sure I will by the time you guys see this, but I got several e-cards from you guys. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys. And all of the birthday wishes. Oh my goodness gracious, you guys, on my community post when I put the picture up of my dad and I. Precious, y'all are precious to me. Just precious. Y'all know that though. But, you know I don't have to say it, but I thank you guys so much. You guys touch my heart so very much. I appreciate y'all so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You know, everybody, all the birthday wishes. Goodness gracious. I was blown away. I was blown away, you guys. Just completely. Anyway, I'm not going to cry, so I'll be back in a little while, okay? All right. Bye-bye. Okie dokie, everybody. I'm back home, sitting here in my kitchen eating area at my table. And I want to go ahead and show you my necklace. I changed necklaces, so I wanted to show you the necklace that Kristen got for me. And I want to show you the one thing that I got with that lovely birthday gift certificate. And I want to talk to you about what my plans are moving forward with my decor. Real quick, that won't take me just a second to tell you that. So here is my necklace. It was called Trust Your Journey necklace. This is from Brighton, as I said, and it came in this lovely package. Look at that. It's always so pretty, Brighton. And the box, I already put it in the garage, but the box that it came in was just, it was lovely, you know? But Mariam Nassirbegli, Nassirbegli, was the creator of this necklace. And the colors used are, quote, just joyful, happy colors. And you know, I'm into all of these different colored stones. Like I say, Kristen pays attention to the littlest of details. And this is also a reversible necklace, so I don't have to wear it stone side up. I can wear it on the silver side too. It is super, super, super pretty. So she said that there are 38 Swarovski. I can never pronounce that. Swarovski? Oh my goodness. Crystals. And it takes them 26.5 hours to make one of these necklaces at Brighton. And she wrote me down all these fun facts because she says, I know you'll haul it, Mom, so I figured I'd give you the facts. And she said the meaning behind this is embracing change and embracing what it is. So you know what I didn't bring out here? It came with three little free gifts. And she said, let me go see if I can find the three tote bags that came with this. Okie dokie, I'm back. Here are the three tote bags that came with this. And Kristen said, you know, the trust your journey, since I'm fixing to go on a journey, she felt like was really apropos. I'm telling you, she's something. So here are the three that came. This was a free gift. These were free gifts with this, the purchase of this necklace. One was a little tote bag, and it says charger on it, like all your chargers, your phone chargers and whatnot. Now, as y'all know, I pretty much have my Vera bags and stuff, but that doesn't mean that I couldn't take, especially one of these for my little laundry basket, but and that I couldn't put, you know, a pair of shoes in here. It says girlfriends. Is she not something, Krista? She says, Kristen, how did you get them to give you? And she said, Mom, they're free. It was just meant to be. She said it was free with the purchase, and she received these girlfriends. And that funny that I'm going on a girlfriend's cruise. Things just, you know, happen. And then the other one is, wash me. And these are lovely tote bags, and they all have a drawstring. Check it out. You know? Anyway, I think I'll put this in the bottom of my suitcase, you know, and use this as my laundry bag. And who knows, I might find something to do with the other two too, but it's so cute. But there it is, Trust Your Journey necklace. So pretty. And then it is reversible to just a silver on the other side. I love it. So that's what Kristen got me for my birthday, and I didn't bring over what Chris got me. And this was more of a joke. He got me a beautiful card that I'm not gonna show you the card, but everybody got me cards, which we're not gonna go there, but sorry, I have to get up again. Let me show you what Chris got me, here we go. We happened to be in Walmart the other morning. You know, when I got the plates and the tablecloth and everything, and I was walking by the Pioneer Woman stuff, you know, and I said, oh, Chris, look, she's got cutting boards. I love these. Well, bless his heart, I had these sitting on the counter when I came out with my birthday card. They come in a set of two, and I think it's like $20. And when I was in there, they had a set that would match my plates. They must not have had that, you know, when he went back to get this, but he picked this up for me, and you know, I didn't have the heart to say that, so I think, knowing him, because he's really good with stuff like that, knowing him, they just didn't have it, and he went ahead and picked this up for me. But aren't they cute? They're nice, too. Very nice. I don't know that I'll use them to cut on. I'll probably use them for decor of some sort, but I thought they were super pretty. So he got me the cutting boards. And the cruise, y'all, you know, come on. He got me the cruise. I didn't need anything big, you know. So, and we, some years we'll go elaborate and get, you know, each other big gifts, and other years we won't, you know, it doesn't have to be. I'm not a big one on gift giving so much as I am about being with my family, and that's always way more important to me than anything anybody could ever give me, although I love my necklace. I don't mean to say that, you know. I love my necklace. So anyway, I also received another gift from one of my subbies, and she actually sent me, and I don't know whether she will want me to say her name, so I'm going to err on the side of caution here and not, but she sent me a gift certificate card to, and she somehow figured out how to do it through Princess Cruises, bless her heart, and she sent me a gift card, and I'm like, oh my goodness, so I need to get with my travel agent. Either you can get it with my travel agent and give them the number, and then they'll put it on the, you know, on my folio, what they call my folio, or I can take it to passenger services once I get on board and turn it in there or show it, you know, on my phone, and they'll give me credit on my folio. So thank you so much, honey. You know who you are. And I don't want to mention her name because I'm thinking she might not want me to, but thank you so much. Mwah! I love you. You know that. And then what I picked up from Michael's with my lovely gift certificate today, I'll tell you guys, I was walking through there like a crazy woman. They have some Christmas out, but I don't think they have everything out yet. And so I was looking, and I wanted to buy one item, pretty much one item. And I just couldn't find anything that I really loved until I came across this. Well, it might help. Boy, that kind of popped the balloon, didn't it? I found this. There we go. It was the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. I love it. Absolutely love it. So I got this. And it was, I don't remember how, it was $35, but it was 30% off. So that made it just about perfect. So I will know that this pillow is from that subby from now on, moving forward forever. I'll know it. So I love it. I love it. I think I'm going to put it here. Sorry about the bells. I've got a couple of snowflake pillows, I think. I don't remember what my pillows are for my couch, but I'm thinking I'll put it, you know, like in the middle, on the middle cushion of my couch, either that or in my chair. He'll go in the family room area. It matches the colors. So I love it. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You know who you are too. Thank you guys so much. Everybody was way too good to me between all of the birthday wishes, the gifts, the wonderful sentiment. I'm telling you all, I was blown away. Blown away. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So much from the bottom of my heart. Okay, I wanted to touch on moving forward with my decor plan here. Kristen actually, and we were all sitting in the family room talking yesterday, and Kristen looked at me serious as could be, and she says, Mom, she says, are you going to deconstruct fall before you leave for your trip? And I said, well, I'd thought about it, but I didn't think I would, Kristen, because I didn't want to leave your dad with an empty house, you know, because he really doesn't like it like that, y'all. Chris does not care for it like that. So he looked up over his glasses. He was doing a crossword puzzle or something, sitting in a chair over here, and he looked up and he said, honey, he said, anything that will make your life easier, go ahead and do it. If you feel like it would make your life easier when you get back from your, you know, so that you can have it all done and ready to be decorated for Christmas, he said, go ahead and do it. He said, I don't care. How lucky am I, you guys, to have him? How lucky am I? I mean, he is like an angel, I'm telling you. So I'm thinking about it. I'm about 13 days out from my trip, so it's not like I have a lot of time. I still have a couple of packing videos to go up too. So I'm not sure if I'll get to it. Plus I want to get I don't know whether I'll get my literal packing video up before I leave. I'd like to. So, but I don't know whether I have enough hours in the day to do all of this. It might stress me out a little bit too much before my trip if I try to deconstruct everything, although it is supposed to be easier for me to deconstruct, right? Wasn't that my point of doing my decor like this? As I look around here, it looks pretty fallish in here. I don't know. So I thought I would deconstruct one thing when I'm sitting here because I'm not planning on putting it back on this table. And I wanted to kind of give you an example of how I tried to do things so that when I go to deconstruct my fall and then reconstruct after Christmas, some of the things are going to be already kind of constructed and I'll just have to kind of put the finishing touches on them. So let me show you what I mean here. Okay, let me move you this way. Okay, here's my dough bowl. There it is. I was never so happy as I was with how this dough bowl turned out, you guys. I have been super, super happy with it. It has been lovely. And there's the centerpiece. I've got the candle lit over there. There's the centerpiece I made for this table. And I've got the tablecloth on the table from yesterday that I'm just gonna leave on here. I've decided I'm gonna leave this tablecloth on here. And I'm going to use that centerpiece for our Thanksgiving table. I'm not going to do anything elaborate where it's just the same people that were here yesterday. It, you know, we're not fancy people. And so I'm just going to go ahead and just leave this as is probably and just use my nicer dishes. Now I do have a tablecloth I could put on here, but between now and Thanksgiving, I'm just going to leave this tablecloth and that centerpiece on here with these pumpkins. Ugh. And those will be the last things that will get deconstructed and put away. So I thought, well, why don't I show them an example of how I want to go about my deconstructing? I will not be using my dough bowl for Christmas. This table is used, I'm gonna have three red lanterns. If y'all remember last year's decor, I have three beautiful red lanterns that go on this table as my centerpiece. I wanna deconstruct the fall out of this dough bowl right now. And I've got myself one of my big Ziploc bags that I'll give you a link for in the description. And you can see here I have fall dough bowl. And I simply want to just take the fall items out of this dough bowl. So these, and I want to keep them all together in this Ziploc bag. because I'll tell you, I really enjoyed doing my fall this way this year. I don't know what I'm going to do next year, but I'm going to keep this together for now because I may want to reconstruct this dough bowl like this next year, you know? I'm also going to leave the lantern in the dough bowl because I've decided I want to use the lantern in the winter time. And then when I switch out to my spring decor, I'll put that, I had a plant in there, urn with greenery in there. So I just want to leave, but I want to leave the lantern in there for the winter months. So I'm just going to take all of these fall elements though out of the dough bowl here, including these. I have a table downstairs. I have an old kitchen table that we used to use in our other house, and haven't gotten rid of it. So I've decided I'm going to use that as a little bit of a staging area. And all I will do is put things like this that are like kind of decorated. I'm going to turn these off, the fairy lights off completely, and set it on that table down there. And then in January, I will bring it up just like this and then add in the other elements, which if I remember right, are a couple of hearts, three hearts that I got from Pier 1 and a few other accent pieces. And I will add those back in January and redo this arrangement for winter. So that is how I am going to be working on my fall decor. Glitter all over my table now. So that is how I'm going to be deconstructing.
So anyway, I'm not sure how far you all want to be brought along with me in that process, but I will video some of it, I'm sure, and whatever I can get done before I leave town, I can bring to you. And I'm hoping to be pretty much ready to start decorating for Christmas. I get back on November, wee hours of the morning on November the 3rd. And, you know, it's gonna take me a little while to get recovered from that. But pretty quick after that, I'm hoping to start getting, you know, going on my Christmas decorating. And now that my dad and everybody has seen the house looking like this, I'm not going to kill myself to get everything done before Christmas. Or I mean, before Thanksgiving. I don't think it's possible for me to do it. You know, I may get concerned. But I think deconstructing fall is a good idea before I leave for my trip. That way I won't have all that facing me when I get home and I'm kind of tired from jet lag and whatnot. So I think I will try that. I think I will. It will calm my nerves a little bit. So
anyway, I'll get back to that next week and we'll see how far I get. I don't know. But for now, I got my dough bowl deconstructed and the dough bowl itself will sit down on that table in my basement. My basement doesn't get dusty. For whatever reason, it doesn't. So it will just sit down there pretty as a picture, adorning that table down there. And I'll start piling stuff that I can bring kind of right back up. And just have to add a few things to you know, redecorate after Christmas. I think that's going to work out great. Anyway, with all that said, I'm going to end this one. And thank you guys so much for stopping in here again. I hope that all is well with everyone. Thank you to my new subscribers. If you've noticed, I've gone over 24,000 now. Thank you so much. Oh my goodness, I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I love to see that those numbers climb. I appreciate every single one of you who has hit that subscribe button. And if you do subscribe, please be sure to hit the bell so that you never miss an upload. So, but anyway, let me just go into my final words and say that I hope that those of you who might be struggling or suffering with a catastrophic illness or chronic pain, I hope you have someone there with you, taking care of you, helping you get through each day, making the very, very best out of each day. I hope there's nothing weighing on your minds or your hearts, pulling your attention away from where you want it to be or from where it should be.
I love y'all to bits, to bits, to bits, hugs all around, and I keep you in my thoughts and my prayers every single day. And with all that said, I'll just say, until next time, y'all take good care. Bye-bye.